gets it up there quickly to Blake. Roblek shot, it's good. What a play! And Roblek jumps into it and rifles home the first goal of this game. Canada 1, Sweden nothing. Nice one to Sundin. Ready, he scores. Sundin took a look, had lots of time on Joseph.
You know, I thought we played well in the first. In the second period, we just got a little bit, you know, impatient, and you know, they play that style, that torpedo style.
In front, Satrav, whoa, score! Takes that pass, cuts into the shot, scores! Matt Sundin gets his second. Coming in on goal, Zetterberg, score! Sweden in again, cuts in front, score! And Sweden is continuing the rout on Canada. Brewer up over the line, nearly got in, he was in, scores! How about that for the big defenseman for Canada, playing in his first Olympic game? Boy, this might lift his team. The young guy looks like the veteran. Sweden with the puck in control again. They defeat Canada 5-2. How about that?
I was probably just like everyone else in Canada. We were all surprised, and we knew coming in this was not going to be a cakewalk. And maybe the fact that our players saw and realized after game one that it isn't going to be a cakewalk, that they are in for a dogfight, and that the Swedes are good. We know that it's a devastating loss to our country.
We know that the bounce back will be better.
You think something works on paper, but when you put it in the game, and it gets in a competitive environment, sometimes it surprises you and works really well, and sometimes it doesn't.
They pass up the middle, we got burned on two line passes.
Yeah, two line pass.
It was embarrassing.
We'll work more on our defensive part of our game as we move along, and I think if our players are responsible in that way and accountable to each other, things are going to be good.
There would be no easy games for the men. Every opponent would have to be taken seriously. Germany was next. And Canada needed a win.
We're real disappointed about the Sweden loss, but we'll do better in the following rounds.
We know what the German game is. We know the opposition. We scout them, and we know exactly what they're going to do.
Canada's going to dominate this game here tonight.
And then Erhoff fired it away to the line, doesn't get out. Right in front of the net, score! Sakic was alone in front of the net. Trying to pass, it doesn't get very far. The Germans cover up again now. A penalty has been called.
In that game, I got hit from behind. It cut above the eye, and we got a five-minute power play there, so the boys scored two goals while I was getting stitched up in the room.
Adam Foot takes a shot. Scores! Germans bring it in. Good play on the wing. McKay got it in front. Score! Ebstrader ran into the Canadian player in front. Brewer knocked him down. High shot, scored! It came off a stick high. Now, whose stick was it?
Well, the Canadians are not complaining, so obviously it was not a high stick.
What became concerning for us, probably more than losing game one, was the fact that we only beat Germany 3-2. Probably as a group or as a staff, we might have been a little bit more nervous that night, and yet there was still positive energy because we had won.
The narrow margin of victory over the Germans did little to silence the critics. Tension and pressure continued to mount as Canada prepared for their rematch with the defending Olympic champs.
And Dvorak couldn't get the puck up. Long lead pass, and here's a break from Ariel.
Playing against the defending champions is always a difficult thing, and you always call upon your leaders, and as coaches I know you call upon your leaders, your guys that are go-to guys, and obviously Mario stepped up his game.
It's a two-on-one Canada. Correa's the man open. Correa's in, but the shot is taken by the new scores. Mario Lemieux beats Hasek again. And it's 2-1.
and the referee comes over. That might be called back. There's no doubt about the fact that Hasek went back into the net.
That's a goal.
Oh, that's a goal.
You're darn right it is.
It's
that's
in his glove.
No question about it. Mario Lemieux gets a second goal, and the game is tied at two. High slot, but they don't get a shot. They might get one from the blue line here. Knocked at it, but they score. Pressure by Canada here. Curry goes behind the goal. Hangs on. Gets it up. Shot deflected in front of the goal. Hasek somehow got a piece of that by diving out. He and Fleury in a pile together. Here's a centering pass. Shot is deflected up over the crossbar. And Fleury and Hasek had something going. He's hurt though. He's still down. Theron Fleury. He made a good play. He got nailed there by Spacek, or Hamerlich rather.
Hamerlich.
In front of the net. Hit him hard. Knocked him flying.
From behind. Cross checked him.
Comes by Blake out to center ice, and Canada now will meet Finland in the hot and heavy south. No more losing now. This was quite a show.
We had a very emotional game tonight. Thought we played really well. They couldn't skate with us in the third period. They should have four or five penalties, hooking, holding, tripping. We outplayed them in the third period. They talk about we're not a skating team, we can't move the puck, we have no finesse. That's crazy. We outskated him in the ground in the third period.
And then Fleury's knocked down in front of the net.
We would have did what they did tonight. It would be a big story. He blatantly tried to hurt him. And I don't understand it. I think the guy should be suspended for the rest of the tournament. If it was a Canadian player that did it, it would be a big story. But a Czech player did it, it's okay. Am I hot? Yeah, I'm hot. Because I'm tired of people taking shots at Canadian hockey.
I was defending my country. Was I trying to take pressure off the team? At the time, probably not. Did I take pressure off the team? Obviously, I did. But at the time, I was trying to protect the integrity of our game and our country.